Jerre Paxton was in the original class of the Washington Hall of Fame, his Northwest Farms being leading state breeder 12 consecutive years in the 1980s and 90s. Over the first two decades at Emerald Downs, local fans were treated to fantastic performances by Paxton's best runners. Though having passed in 2015, Paxton remains the track's leading stakes-winning owner, with 37 added money triumphs. Taste the Passion was one of the top juvenile fillies of early Emerald Downs seasons and became an incredible blue hen producer for Paxton. Her 2004 foal was Shampoo, the track's top three-year-old filly in 2007 and older mare of 08.
It is Shampoo who is going to scorch away in the U.S. Bank Stakes. On Duty holds down Tig and the rest are not in it at all. And a huge win to Shampoo. Shampoo by three or four lengths to On Duty.
Taste the Passion's next foal was Smarty Deb, arguably the best Emerald Downs juvenile ever.
But she is showing her class, and Smarty Deb two in front of 16th to go, Gallon in second. And let's see her at Monmouth Park, and she's not just a pretty face. She means business, Smarty Deb.
Smarty Deb was the first filly to win the Gottstein here, and the first Emerald Downs runner to make it to the Breeders' Cup. Paxton bred Taste the Passion to Curlin, and the 2010 filly was Stop Shopping Debbie, who raced to a perfect 9-for-9 record at Emerald Downs, 8 stakes wins. She often contended with talented stablemates Blueberry Smoothie and Going to the Window.
Stop Shopping Debbie drifting out under a left-handed whip, now switching sticks a little, no back to the left hand, and Rocco Bowen in front on Stop Shopping Debbie. She's got him, and she's going to win and remain undefeated. And Stop Shopping Debbie puts her mind to the task and wins by 3 lengths.
There were many more on the long list, including 5-time stakes winner Elusive Horizon, who never lost around 2 turns. Jerre Paxton, forever a legend in Washington breeding and racing.